Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 96 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 166 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 167. Question 167. You have the app service plans shown in the following table. App service plan named ASP1, it has Windows operating system and located in West US region. Plan ASP2 has Windows operating system and located in Central US region. Plan ASP3 has Linux operating system and located in West US region. You plan to create the Azure web apps shown in the following table. Web app 1 has the runtime stack .NET Core 3 and should be located in the West US region. Web app 2 has the runtime stack of ASP.NET 4.7 and should be located in West US region. You need to identify which app service plans can be used for the web apps. What should you identify? To understand it better, let's go to a diagram and then we will go to Azure portal. We will try to understand app service plan and app service in this diagram. So app service plan is set of computer resources for web app to run, and app service could be a web application, REST API or mobile backend, and definitely web app may be working with the storage blob service or storage service and database service. Let's go to Azure portal. We are in Azure portal and we'll go to resource groups. We'll go to RG1, and RG1 has three app service plans as mentioned in the question. So ASP1 is residing in West US region, ASP2 is residing in Central US location, and ASP3 is residing in West US location. Further, ASP1 has Windows operating system. ASP2 has Windows operating system, and ASP3 has Linux operating system as mentioned in the question. Now let's try to create a web app. We are creating a web app. Create, and we'll give the name AzureWala web app 1. So it resolves here. Now selected runtime stacks are, in .NET we do have .NET 8, .NET 7, .NET 6, ASP.NET 4.8 and ASP.NET 3.5 only. Therefore .NET Core 3.0 is not supported anymore. Since the question was written earlier, therefore we can assume that the new question will arrive in the exam with .NET 6, 7 or 8. So first we'll check for ASP.NET 4.8, and if you can see that Linux is grayed out, means it just support the Windows operating system. And if we scroll down and if we select West US, it will automatically direct us to ASP1, which is the plan with Windows operating system and residing in West US. Further, if we select .NET 7, it does allow us to switch between operating system. It means .NET Core and .NET 5, 6, 7 and 8 supports both the operating system. If we select the operating system to Linux. It will automatically choose here ASP3 available plan. And if we select Windows operating system here, it would automatically choose to ASP1, which is having the Windows operating system. Let's move back to question. Therefore, .NET Core and .NET 5, 6, 7, and 8 supports Linux operating system as well as Windows operating system. And the Web App 2, which is the ASP.NET 4.7 framework application, it just supports the Windows operating system. Further, both of these applications supports the app service plans which are residing in the same location. Therefore, it will support West US location application plans only. Web App 1 will support ASP1 and ASP3 plan, since ASP1 is having the operating system Windows and ASP3 is having operating system Linux. Both are supported by .NET Core applications, as well as both the plans are residing in West US location. For Web App 2, Web App 2 will only support the plan which are residing in West US and having the operating system Windows. Therefore, it will support the ASP1 only. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.